to all who swear allegiance to the cross of Christ. A call to true humility, to live our lives responsibly, to deepen our devotion to the cross at any price. Let us then be sober, moving only in the Spirit, as aliens and strangers in a hostile foreign land. The message we're proclaiming is repentance and forgiveness, the offer of salvation to the dying race of man. To love the Lord our God is the heartbeat of our mission, the spring from which our service overflows. Across the street or around the world, the mission. As a candle is consumed by the passion of the flame, spilling light unsparingly throughout a darkened room, let us burn to know him deeper than our service flaming bright. We'll radiate his passions and blaze with holy light. Holy light. To love the Lord our God is the heartbeat of our mission, the spring from which our service overflows. Across the street or around the world, the mission's still the same. Proclaim and live the truth in Jesus' name. To love the Lord our God is the heartbeat of our mission, the spring from which our service overflows.
Yes, good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Just like to have a word of prayer as we begin our program for this evening. Let us pray. O Lord, our God, your name is excellent. We know that you do all things well. And ever since sin came into our world and brought in its train death, what an enemy this has been, as described in your word. Today, as we reflect on the life of one of your great son, your soldier, the Gordon Martinborough pioneer, stalwart, administrator, evangelist, what a model. We pray, God, that you will be with everyone on this platform today, that you will guide us, hold us up. Remember the Martinborough family in a special way. Continue to grant them strength to go through this difficult time, this period of separation. And we pray, God, today that this program will help us to bring some relief, some comfort of your presence, even as we reflect on the great contribution he has made. So bless us today. Guide those who will administrate and bless every aspect of our program today. May we see you, Lord, lifted up. Thank you for what you will do for and through us. As we mourn, not like those who have no hope, but may your hope ever ring in our hearts. We thank you for this. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor Henry. And welcome to you, our brothers and sisters in the Guyana Conference, elsewhere in the Caribbean Union and Inter-American Division as well, and around the world. I'm Easton Marks, one of the hosts of this evening's wake, celebrating the life and ministry of Gordon O. Martinborough. My co-hosts, Pastor Sherwin A.E. White of the South Leeward Conference and Yasmin Bowman of the Guyana Conference, are on with us and will share in this evening's experience. Our first order of business is to ask you, our brothers and sisters in the audience, in this vast field in which Pastor Martinborough served, to join us and welcome his family, the Martinboroughs, with your personal expressions in the chat. We will say it here on your behalf, but you have an opportunity now to go to the chat and write your own expressions to them as we welcome them to this evening sitting with us as we gather to ask God's blessing, the blessing of peace, the blessing of physical and emotional strength, hope, and courage as we march forward. Wife and ministry partner, Mrs. Waveney Martinborough, their children, Esther, her husband, Marco, Samuel, and John, we welcome you. And of course, once again, we offer you our support, our condolences, and our promise to keep praying for you. Pastor Martinborough's sisters, Dolly Teixeira, her husband Clement, and their children. The younger sister, Shirley McGarrell, her husband Roy, whom Pastor Martinborough comfortably referred to as, quote, my best friend, and their children. Family, thank you all for allowing us to do this today. We loved your husband, father, brother, uncle, our pastor, Gordon O. Martinborough, whom we sometimes called Marty, but with a lot of love under that. And we certainly love you all. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, because Gordon Martin Borrow meant so much to so many of us for so long, this evening we will hear tributes and have contributions from people all across the Inter-American Division territory and beyond. Most certainly many from his native land, Guyana, including the church where that started, Buxton on the east coast of Demerara. We will wind up at the church where he last worshiped in Florida, as one of his colleagues there, another retired minister, shared about his impact on his life. Please stay with us for the duration of this three-hour program, celebrating a remarkable life, an outstanding ministry, that of Gordon O. Martin Borrow, pastor, evangelist, and church administrator. For a word now, my co-host, Sherwin White, will speak to some practical housekeeping matters, and then we will proceed with the program. Pastor White.
Thank you very much, Pastor Marks. And it's a joy for me to share with you this evening in this special program where we are remembering the life of a great man. In every arena of life, there is or there are individuals who stand out. If you're a cricketer, you would think of Clive Lloyd, Garfield Sobers. And when these individuals are at the wicket, you are almost assured that victory is sure. Whenever they are dismissed, you are worried. In the realm of Christianity, for some reason, it appears as if God, he has given to some greater gifts than others. The one that is responsible for us being on this platform here. He was a great administrator, a great evangelist, and a remarkable pastor. And this afternoon, we have individuals who fit within this category. But more than that, because he was a pastor, he cared so much for the parishioners. And today, we have so many parishioners, laymen and laywomen from across the Inter-American Division who are here on the platform with us. I would just like you to know that this afternoon, you can have the privilege of just viewing what we are experiencing here on Zoom, on YouTube, in the comfort of your homes. You can view it on your widescreen television. So let me just invite you at this moment to just send a message to a friend or a loved one that tell them that they can view what we are encountering right now on Flatbush SDA on YouTube, that is Flatbush SDA, or on the Guyana Conference, that is on YouTube also. You can also find us on Facebook Live at the Guyana Conference. For this afternoon, the family, they're delighted to have all of us here on the platform. And they would like to hear from many individuals. There are those who have shared with us their video tributes. Others will be doing that live. For those who will be doing their tributes live, because we prefer to hear from 100 rather than 10%, each individual would be limited. Each individual will be limited to 3 minutes. There are a few luminaries that we have on the platform who have been assigned 5 minutes. What will happen for those who will be speaking for 3 minutes? At 2 minutes and 30 seconds, there will be a recording played in the background signaling that you have 30 seconds to conclude. And because we would like to hear from as many individuals as possible, regrettably, at the 3 minute mark, we will have to mute you. So what we're encouraging you to do is to make whatever you have to say very concise. That's what we're asking you to do so that individuals can benefit. I would also want to say to you that we would like you to, you know, follow the protocols of Zoom. Those of you with your cameras on, the family will like to have this moment memorialized. Therefore, your cameras, make sure that it is on correctly at all times. And once again, remember to utilize the chat. because what we are doing here, it is recorded, and the family would want to read everything. Everything that you have said, the family, they will like to read it in the future. So we are asking you to do so. So it is our privilege to navigate you through this very special week in which we focus on the life of such a great man who has fallen. We know that the devil's camp has not won, because the Bible says, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. We know that Dr. Martin Borough, he is only resting. The one who brought us the prayer, that was Pastor Bertie Henry, who is the treasurer of the Caribbean Union Conference. That's the conference that Dr. Martin Borough served as president. Pastor Marks, it is over to you again.
Thank you, Pastor White. Ladies and gentlemen, without ado, we will begin receiving tributes and all of the contributions, many of them musical, as we said before, from some of the furthest points in this great division in which Dr. Martin Borough served. We will begin, I believe, appropriately at the headquarters of the work in the Caribbean Union Conference. And for that, we will go to Dr. Kern Tobias, who now serves as our union president. Dr. Tobias, we welcome you. Thank you for agreeing to be here this evening. Good evening, sir. Go ahead.
Please unmute.
It's muting every time, so please keep me unmuted. Very happy to welcome you from the sunny Caribbean and the warmth of the love that we have felt as members of the Caribbean Union constituency from our own beloved Dr. Gordon Martin Borough. I represent the Caribbean Union Conference, of which he was president, and also the Guyana Conference that gave him as a gift not only to Guyana and to the Caribbean Union, but also to Inter-America and the world. On behalf of Pastor Johnson Frederick, our executive secretary, and you already heard from Pastor Bertie Henry, a son of the soil of Guyana, as our third officer, and all the other directors of the Caribbean Union, administrators of the fields. We have 10 fields, territories, 6 conferences, and 4 missions. On behalf of all these leaders and members, we join with the Martin Borough family in mourning the loss of this great son of the soil. Dr. Martin Borough has been hailed as one of our finest sons, not only for his ministry, but for his contribution to ministry. It is no secret that he has empowered so many humble and simple ministers, I myself included, because I am not one of the esteemed evangelists. I have always been a humble pastor, but because of the empowerment that he provided, providing sermon illustrations and series on family ministry and health, many of us have been able to add substance to our evangelistic and outreach experiences and evangelistic crusades. And so we are really happy to identify with this tremendous leader of God's church. He modeled family, his dear wife, Sister Waveney, outstanding as a support. They have always been together. The warmth of their love could be felt, and the strength of his family through his children, Dr. Esther Biamonte and her husband, and of course, Samuel and John. We have been so blessed to see the modeling. Of course, he also modeled health. you know, I mean, we know that after some of us get married, we put on a few extra pounds, but somehow Dr. Martin Barrow has been able to maintain that physique. He was always brisk and businesslike, going about God's business in so many ways. In so many ways, we can celebrate his life and ministry as an administrator, as a pastor, as an evangelist, as an equipper of God's disciples, of God's children. And today we join with the family in celebration, despite our pain, despite our grief. I'm happy that at the Caribbean, in the Caribbean Union, at our university, the University of the Southern Caribbean, we were able to give Dr. Martin Barrow his flowers while he was alive. He has contributed, he had contributed so much that it was evident that he needed to be given some respect for his contribution. And so today we mourn his passing, and we know that even though he has departed, the Bible says that the righteous perishes, and no man takes it to heart, none considering that the righteous is taken away from the evil to come. We know that he is preserved until the glorious day of Jesus' return. May God comfort every member of the family and all of those of us who grieve.
Thank you, Dr. Tobias. Thank you. You've always been gracious, and we felt it again today. Thank you very much. This time, we are going to go to Guyana Conference, the home conference of Pastor Martin Barrow, a conference in which he served as many things. And today, we will hear from the Executive Secretary, Pastor Sanko. The president is not in country. I understand he will be in person at the funeral service tomorrow in Florida. Today, deputizing from the homeland, the Executive Secretary, Pastor Sanko. The home conference of Pastor Martin Barrow, a conference in which he served as many things. And today we will hear from the Executive Secretary,
Pastor Sanko. Is a sum total of all those he has encountered.
I understand he will be in person at the funeral service tomorrow.
Pastor Gordon Martin Barrow
today
has been a mentor and a spiritual father to me. Ever since I was a teenager, he had greatly impacted my life. And I was using his everlasting gospel lessons, Operation Andrew,
I do believe,
to witness to my friends one and one,
is a
and many of them became baptized and joined the remnant church. I came back home as a young pastor, Pastor Gordon. Week after my life, Dr. Garnett, and I was using the assignment to go and work everlasting Martin Barrow lessons
in the Bellodrome
operation and evangelistic campaign.
To witness to my friend, one-on-one,
but eventually many of them became baptized and joined the instruction of the then president. I came back home as a young pastor, while I was the personal ministries director of the conference, in the upper class evangelistic campaign at Regency Hotel. And we I learned from him once again, Garnett,
and that was many lessons
to go and work. Over the years, I have gotten closer to the operation and evangelistic campaign.
With his
contemporaries, Christmas cards, and the end of the year, they give me regular
baptism.
He has taught me many then, President. I came back to learn 20, a young pastor, the ministry's director.
I have not learned to be as punctual as he was
in the upper class evangelistic campaign
to be organized
at Regency Hotel,
to be a strategic
planner. I learned from him once again,
Garnett,
and I was many lessons
over the years. I have
prudently closer to give attention to details
with respect
to
the
I learned from him.
Obviously, that was not me repeating myself. That was not Pastor Sanko repeating himself. It was a technical situation that we encountered. I am optimistic that in a few seconds, we are going to get it right. And I believe we are ready now to roll the tape with Pastor Sanko. Pastor Sanko couldn't be in person. He is officiating at a dedication service in the conference somewhere this afternoon. All right, let's go back to the control room. Pastor Hugh McKenzie. He is officiating at a dedication service in the
I do believe that a person encountered in his lifetime, Pastor Gordon Martin Barrow, has been a mentor and a spiritual father to me. Ever since I was a teenager, he had greatly impacted my life, and I was using his everlasting gospel lessons, Operation Andrew, to witness to my friends on one-on-one, and many of them became baptized and they joined the Remnant Church. I came back home as a young pastor. I'd just completed my first crusade or evangelistic campaign. We baptized 100 persons, started a new church, and about a week after, Dr. Garnett gave me the assignment to go and work with Pastor Martin Barrow in the Belladrum evangelistic campaign. I protested, but eventually I had to comply with instruction from the then president. Subsequently, I worked with him while I was the personal ministries director of the conference in the upper class evangelistic campaign at Regency Hotel. And I learned from him once again many lessons. Over the years, I have gotten closer to him, and he would send me Christmas cards at the end of the year and give me regular feedback. He has taught me many things. I have not learned to be a perfectionist as he was. I have not learned to be as punctual as he was, but I've learned to be principled, to be organized, to be a strategic planner, to be intentional, to plan prudently, to give attention to details, to execute effectively and with excellence. I learned from him to give feedback. He would often give me feedback. In the Belladrum campaign, he asked me to teach the Sabbath seminar. And so I thought I did that. At the end, he walked up to me and he said, "I told you to teach it, not preach it." I learned. We worked also on several initiatives, and I have learned so many things from this mighty man of God, to be prayerful, to be prudent. And so I thank God for him, and I express on behalf of my family sincere condolences to Sister Waveney, to Esther, to Johnny, and to every member of the family. We have lost a mighty man of God, but his legacy will continue to live on with me and with many others. May God continue to bless you.
Thank you. Thank you, Pastor Jamal Sanko. And that's the Executive Secretary of the Guyana Conference, for sharing along with Dr. Kern Tobias, the President of the Caribbean Union Conference. We will continue with our tributes. The Caribbean Union Conference, at the time when Pastor Martin Barrow served as the president, surely we did not have as many fields as we have today. We currently have 10 fields that's within the Caribbean Union, and we will be hearing from the presidents of the fields. At this time, we will listen to President Roger Stevens, followed by President Danforth Francis. Pastor Stephen, he's the president of the St. Lucia Mission, and Pastor Francis, he is the president of the East Caribbean Conference, comprising of Barbados and Dominica.
Today we celebrate the life of a great man, an icon, a legendary. We can truly agree that an oak has fallen, a cedar of Lebanon has fallen. Dr. Gordon O. Martin Barrow was a selfless servant of the living God. He gave his life and all for the service of God, and reaching persons not only in Trinidad and the Caribbean Union, but throughout the Inter-American Division and the world. Many of the younger generations may never have met him or gotten to know him, but through his work, especially the way he amalgamated the family life and evangelism, health and evangelism, his work, of course, reached so many. I personally use his series, the Happy Life, Happy Family Life series. And through this, so many persons were baptized. And I'm sure many persons who are listening today and celebrating his life, we all would have used it. And as a result, so many thousands gave their hearts to Jesus. We celebrate the life of this man. And many of us can use so many wonderful examples of his work. Sister Wavney and the children, the extended family, we celebrate with you. And we say thank God for just giving us this man, this great man, so that he could have touched and impressed our lives and make such an invaluable contribution to the expansion of the kingdom of God. May as you celebrate, remember Psalm 30 verse 5, which says, weeping may endure but for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. We shall all meet him again on the sea that looks like glass. What a great reunion that will be when Jesus himself will be our maker and our king. God bless you all.
I am R. Danforth Francis, president of the East Caribbean Conference of Seventh-day Adventists. It is on behalf of that organization that I express deepest and sincere condolences to the Martin Boer family. I want you to know that we were blessed by the life and ministry of Pastor Gordon Martin Boer. He was a deeply spiritual and devoted mentor pastor to me and countless others. He was an astute and passionate evangelist who not only successfully executed his craft and vision under the tent, baptizing thousands across the Union, but he also documented what he did, creating tools so that his contemporaries and we, the generation that followed him, would be able to develop capacity that we could outdo him. In that sense, he was selfless. We thank God for the thousands of souls who were added to our conference in membership through his ministry, directly and through the activities of his mentees. Tools like the New Life series, Operation Andrew, and other material. We thank God for his general leadership. Eternity alone will reveal the extent of the impact of his ministry. We pray God will comfort his wife, Wavney, and the children, and may all of us be strengthened by the knowledge that he fought a good fight. He's ended his course. Now there's laid up for him a crown of life. May he rest till the life giver calls his name. And may we who remain today be there on that grand resurrection morning to hear once again the distinctive laugh and see his radiant smile. May we then live with that hope. And may God bless us all. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you very much. Two men of God, their lives have been influenced and impacted by the life of this great cedar. Can I say a great green heart or a purple heart from the forest of Guyana, who has fallen? And oh, how we can speak of his legacy not only in Guyana and the Caribbean, but throughout the Inter-American Division. God bless you and the family members. Our prayers are with you. Remember, the chat is open. Kindly feel free to post your tributes there. A little while from now, we will be identifying a few of the tributes and we will be reading them. Of course, Suriname borders Guyana, but Pastor Martin Borrow had direct supervision of Suriname while he served as the president of the Caribbean Union Conference. There's a special musical tribute coming to us from Suriname at this time. It is well with my soul.
Like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well, it is well with my soul. Well, with my soul, it is well, it is well with my soul. Sight freedom and tailless of my heart, my fertile. Water is here, niet geweest. Vergeef, spreid u Satan zijn schrik en zint op uw kruis. Roemt in mij ook mijn geest. Het is mij goed wat mijn God mij beschikt. Is mij goed, wat mijn God. Het is mij goed, wat mijn God mij beschikt. And Lord, haste the day when my fate shall be sight. The trump shall resound, and the Lord shall descend. Even so, it is well with my soul. It is well
Amen. I'm sure that's what every heart is saying. Immortal lyrics. Peace like a river. May God give us all peace. And on this weekend in particular, that's our prayer for the Martinborroughs, that peace would be in their soul. We're going to shift gears and go live to Guyana for Pastor Margaret Ramsaran. After we hear from Pastor Margaret Ramsaran, we will jump out to Grenada for a tribute from the president of that field, Dr. Clinton Lewis. And then we will come back into the United States and hear from Elder David Carr, who was a longtime member of the executive committee going back to the times when Pastor Martinborrough was president and chairman of the executive committee of the Guyana Conference. First, to Pastor Margaret Ramsaran. Please welcome her. Receive her as she shares from her heart. Go ahead, Pastor. Unmute yourself and speak.
Good afternoon, everyone. This occasion has given me an opportunity to go down memory lane. My first contact with Pastor Martinborrough was in April 1968, when as district pastor, he baptized my mother and her three daughters. Ever since that day, he has left an indelible impression on our minds and has positively influenced our lives. He was our first Seventh-day Adventist pastor, having come from the Roman Catholic Church. And what a pastor he was. He did not only baptize us, but he nurtured and equipped us to be faithful disciples through his weekly classes of Bible doctrines and denominational history. As a matter of fact, he was my mother's icon. There is not a pastor who ministered in our district during her lifetime who did not hear about Pastor Martinborrough and was encouraged to be like him. Whenever he had reason to talk to you, he spoke gently, but firmly and persuasively. He did nothing or said nothing without beginning and ending with prayer. He was a man of much prayer and practiced team ministry. Whenever he visited homes, it was with his dear wife. At the conclusion of services at church, be it day or night, he would make several trips in his little blue bug, as we called it, to take everyone home. When he could not do it, his wife deputized. He practiced self-denial and sacrifice. When I met him, he served and shared a room with his wife and two children in an old sister's house until he found a place. Then he visited our single parent family and brought us a 5-pound tin of powder milk. We thought that the pastor was rich, but we later realized that the gift was not from his abundance, but his lifestyle of sacrifice and self-denial. He stayed in touch with our family all through the Christian journey. He officiated at the wedding of my two sisters. When my mother knew that her days were numbered, she called him in Florida and requested him to funeralize her. He promised. He bought his ticket and made good his promise. When the Guyana Conference was in need of a Sabbath school director 3 years ago, I was told that he recommended me. After my mother's funeral, he visited me at home to inquire about my personal well-being and future plans.
All right. We apologize for that, but we are working with the 3 minutes rule. That's what we are doing because we, as the family is desirous of having many individuals speak. So we will go to Grenada at this time.
Sabbath afternoon greetings to everyone. On behalf of the administration and the membership of the Grenada Conference of Seventh-day Adventists, I hereby express condolences to the family, the relatives, and membership of the Guyana Conference of Seventh-day Adventists on the passing of God's servant, Pastor Gordon Martinborough. We thank God for Elder Martinborough's contribution to equipping and spiritual formation of many of our pastors in the Grenada Conference, and for the many souls he was instrumental in leading to Christ through the two family evangelistic efforts he conducted. I will always remember him stressing repeatedly while he conducted the first evangelistic effort, pastors must be men of prayer. Thank God for the certainty of the resurrection as his servant, Elder Martinborough, awaits his call to a glorious eternity.
Hello, for thank you very much. At this time, we will have David Carr, Elder David Carr.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is David Carr. I've been asked to speak on my experience with Pastor Martinborough as an administrator when I served on the executive committee of the Guyana Conference of Seventh-day Adventists. I had known Pastor Martinborough and his family for quite some time before then, but as a lay person, I was on that committee for a number of years. And one of the things that I recognized in Pastor Martinborough, that he was not only a good pastor and a great evangelist, but he was an administrator par excellence. As most of us know, in committees, whether it's church board or conference committee or even at work, there would be always persons there who may not agree with the chairman or may have their own points to make. Pastor Martinborough was very gentle. He would listen. He would be courteous. And even at times when that person or person may not be going in his direction, he would gently and quietly, you know, bring them in line. And I think it's that kind of level of being an administrator that impressed me the most. I know of his other qualities, but I sat there as a young person. And at that time, I was working in the government and attended board meetings and other things. I recognized that Pastor Martinborough had an exceptional gift as an administrator. I have sat in several other committees at a union level too, and I could say that Pastor Martinborough was an administrator beyond all knowledge. And so what impacted me was is how he dealt with problems, how he dealt with crises. He never got flustered, as you all know. He's very quiet, always smiling, and would always, even as a lay person, he would encourage us to contribute to the meeting. He just didn't see us there as lay persons, but he asked us to contribute. And even after meetings, he would call and find out, well, how do things go? Do you have any more contributions to make? And I want to say that is what impacted me the most as I served in that committee. And so to his wife, Sister Waveney Martinborough, his children, Esther, Samuel and John, his sisters, Dolly and Shirley. I want to repeat the words that King David said when Abner was slain. He said, "Do you not know that a prince and a great man has fallen this day in Israel?" Let us remember that a great man and a prince, a great administrator, has fallen in Israel. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Elder Carr. And at this time, we will turn our attention to a few written tributes. I will invite Yasmin Bowman. She is going to, at this time, share with us at least 6 of the written tributes to the family at this time. Yasmin, it is over to you.
Okay. Thank you, Pastor White. Let me go to the chat and see some of the tributes. Okay, we have a tribute here from Dr. Leslie V. McMillan, and it says, from your fellow worker and friend, Dr. Leslie McMillan, I express the only sure source of comfort and his eternal and his life eternal as Jesus the Christ. It is only he that matters at this time. To the family, I say the comfort from out of this world is only found in Jesus. By faith, take advantage of him each day, and he will supply all that you need. We will do the same, the family and I. Plus, it is only Jesus Christ who has promised to wake up your father, husband, and relative. Without that taking place, he cannot see the second coming. But good thing is that God the Father has placed judgment in the hands of Christ, and so he knows all the wonderful exploits of Dr. Martin Borrow for his glory and honor. As a just judge, he will act with the award given him long before his falling asleep. Let us remain, continue in Christ Jesus, and enjoy our reward, which will be sealed the same time with Elder Martin Borrow. The next tribute is from Winston Bourne. Oh, sorry, that's a compliment, not a song. I'm sorry. Pastor Floyd, thanks to Pastor Floyd Johnson of Texas from the Bahamas, I send condolences to the family of one of our most esteemed pastors from Guyana Conference to the IED. The next tribute, as an elder, Hubert Musa. As an elder, I learned a lot of things from Dr. Martin Borrow in the area of evangelism, which put me in good stead. The next tribute is from Marjorie Morgan, and it reads, my deepest condolences to Waveney and children, Shirley and Dolly and their families on your great loss. May the great comforter sustain you in your hour of sorrow. From Marjorie Lawrence. And the 6th one for this segment, from Ingrid Walker, I hope I'm pronouncing it correctly. It says, thank you, Sister Waveney, Esther, Samuel, and Johnny, and other family members for sharing him with us. We grieve with you. We give God thanks on behalf of the Walker and Clark families. I thank you.
Thank you, Yasmin. Thank you. And we will continue now with 2 conference presidents. We will begin in the South Caribbean Conference, Trinidad, and then we'll rush over to the North Caribbean Conference. And we are going to hear now from President Leslie Moses, who heads the South Carib field. And then we will go to Pastor Desmond James, who heads the North Caribbean Conference territory. Pastor Moses. Thank you, sir. Unmute yourself and speak.
Happy Sabbath. On behalf of the administration, the pastoral staff, the office staff, and all the members of the South Caribbean Conference, I'm here today to express condolences to the Martin Boroughs. Pastor Martin Borrow was a giant. He was a man like no other. Of course, he revolutionized evangelism. And my ministry, I would say, was changed because of his intervention. In 1988, I was asked to leave my district to go and work with him in a crusade. I hesitated, I protested to the president, then President Pastor Mitchell, but he insisted, you need to go. And I'm glad I went. Of course, it wasn't sweet at the beginning, but when I found what he was doing, I enjoyed it to the very end. He had come to Trinidad to do the Family Life series where many, many, many individuals gave their hearts to the Lord. At the end of it, I said to him, Elder, I want to use this material. He said, use it. And I've been using it for many years. I baptized many. I'm not an evangelist, but the sermons were so structured, so well ordered, that I was able to do much with them. More recently, I used his other material, and we were dialogue up to quite recently, last year, I think. We were talking about him coming to Trinidad to do something for the upper class. Of course, that was not to be. So we will miss him. Sister Martinborough, I mourn with you and your children and the other family members, Sister McGarrell and others. But we know that the Lord is coming and what a difference that will make. You know, Jesus himself said, he comes quickly, I end with this. He which testifieth these things saith, surely I come quickly. And then John wrote, even so come, Lord Jesus. Let's pray for the coming of the Lord. That will make a big change in all of what we're doing here. And by his grace, we will see Elder Martinborough again. Very good friend, a wonderful person. I will miss him greatly. God bless you. God bless you and keep you.
Pastor Moses, before you go away, I just want to say to you again, I am so, so impressed by your generosity. When you and I spoke on the phone, you said all that you just said, and it's not too common in pastoral ministry to hear such generosity from pastor to pastor. And I thank you for being a good example, along with the previous pastors who spoke, but you and I spoke more in detail about the impact he has had on you, and it came through this afternoon, and I'm sure the family is grateful. We are all blessed. Thank you. We go now to Pastor President Desmond James in the North Caribbean Conference. Pastor James? Unmute yourself, sir, and you'll be able to go.
Thank you, Pastor Marks. On behalf of the administration and 16,000 members of the North Caribbean Conference, I'm honored this afternoon to pay tribute to a legend, a great man whose word and works have radically transformed the church and the landscape of mission in the Caribbean Union. Indeed, as we contemplate his passing, we realize that something vast and noble has passed from among us. And as a young preacher, there are many holy hallmarks that can bookend his life. He was a model pastor, a passionate preacher, one with the dignity and class that characterized his ministry. But if I were to recall two that were indelibly impressed on my consciousness, the first has to do with his passion for evangelism. He had an indomitable passion for evangelism. He had a divine love affair with evangelism. I was fortunate as a young preacher when he was appointed to be the president of the Caribbean Union. And as I listened to his passionate speech, I can vividly recall how passionately, yet unapologetically, he reaffirmed to us as young preachers that this one thing we must do, and that's evangelism. That must be the heartbeat of our mission. And secondly, as he mellowed in years, I admired the heightened sense of his ministerial calling, the dignity, the love and passion for ministry, the love for human beings. We were happy and privileged in the North Caribbean Conference to entertain him at one time in the Great Crusade. He was an excellent model. And indeed, today, we want to express deepest sympathy to Mrs. Martinborough. Be assured that as you go through this season of sorrow. Our concerted prayers will add to your quiet strength. And may God continue to bless you. Thank you for sharing this wonderful gift from us. It will live with us, and though dead, yet he speaketh eloquently to generations yet unborn. And we look forward to the day when we shall have the privilege to see him again, when death itself shall die, and there'll be no more sorrow, no more pain, but we shall live forever and ever. May God bless you and strengthen you. On behalf of the peoples and administration of the North Caribbean Conference, bye.
Thank you, Pastor James. God bless you and the field, North Caribbean Conference. We'll have some music now, and then we will continue with prose and poetry from those who are next on the queue. But first, music, I believe, from the East Jamaica Conference.
True God, yeah, you. You are my strength. Every time I need you, Lord, you are my source, Lord. Lord, we say, so let it be, Lord. So let it be, Lord. Lord, you are my life. Lord, you are my source, Jesus. You are my life, Jesus. You are my bread, Jesus. You are my praise, Jesus. You are my life, Lord.
That was from East Jamaica. So the Jamaica Union has been represented here. Just a brief reminder, because of the nature of the program and the man that's responsible for us being on the platform, the family, they're requesting that they should hear from as many individuals as possible. For that reason, we have assigned 3 minutes for each person who would be delivering a tribute. At 2 minutes and 30 seconds, you would hear an instrumental music being played in the background, signaling that you have 30 seconds. We are not in any way desiring to be rude or disrespectful, but we are obeying the wishes of the family. Remember, you can place your additional tributes within the chat. The family would have all of those pages printed out so that they can read and read and read. At this time, we will now transition to tributes from Pastor Maxwell Blakeney, and then we would have Dr. Hilton Garnett. So Pastor Maxwell Blakeney followed by Dr. Hilton Garnett.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm very happy for the privilege of speaking and paying tribute to Pastor Martin Borough. I ministered with Pastor Martin Borough as a young minister in the Guyana Conference. And while I was working also at the Davis Memorial Hospital, we traveled together very often seeking to raise funds for the Guyana Conference and the hospital in a period when things were very difficult, and I got to know Pastor Martin Borough quite well. He was a pastor who, as a young man, was a pastor who lost his voice for a while because he was going so hard. But just as he's always done, he managed to come right back and be as influential as he was before. He influenced my first attempt to do any kind of public evangelism by operating what was called in 1965, the Thousand Drive in 65 in Guyana. And I was assigned to some people for Bible study. I didn't add to the Thousand, but I had a very good experience. And I thank him for introducing me to that. We became fellow workers, and between 1980 and 83, we spent a lot of time traveling together, trying to raise funds for Guyana and the Davis Memorial Hospital in a period when things were not going that well. And that is when I became acquainted with his devotional life. He prayed very long, personally. And I would wait until he was finished because I didn't pray that long. I would not get down and start praying at the same time. This was in a personal devotion, but we were staying sometimes in the same room. I couldn't stay with him. He prayed. He really spent a long time on his knees. And that, I think, is was reflected in the way he lived. He also paid a lot of attention to his children. While I worked in Trinidad, he would come as president of the Ghana Conference, and then he'd bring them up one by one to my home. And he would be there sitting with them and speaking and counseling and praying. I really admired that aspect of his life. My whole life was changed by my association with Pastor Martin Borough. I'd like to thank Sister Martin Borough for sharing him with us, and pray that God's blessing will rest on her and the children as they go through this period of bereavement. God bless you all.
Thank you, Pastor Blakeney. Dr. Hilton Garnett.
Good afternoon, everyone. Firstly, hello. Sincere condolences to Sister Martin Borough and her children, and to the extended family, the McGarrels and the Teixeiras and others. Those who have known Pastor Martin Borough have testified that he was multi-talented and multi-gifted. By any dimension, the pastor was a consecrated, anointed, godly Christian gentleman. His prayer life was unmatched. When he gets into the car or in any interview, any discussion, he would say, "Let us bow our heads." Pastor Martin Borough was a super organizer. He came to the office every day with a written agenda of items to be accomplished that day. His giftedness was manifested in his brilliance, his exegetical skills. He could make some dull passages of scripture come alive. His administrative abilities were recognized by all those who worked closely with him in the Guyana Conference, the Caribbean Union, and the Inter-American Division. He was a great chairman of boards and committees. Pastor Gorton Martin Borough had the ability to motivate people, especially when it comes to evangelism. He had a great passion for organizing the laity to get involved in evangelism. I recall the occasion when he and I teamed up and organized about 40 lay crusades in the city of Georgetown. Some of those persons never stood behind a pulpit. It was during his tenure as president that he developed the immortal song that still motivates laity and clergy in Guyana. A finished work in all Guyana, be it Berbice or Demerara, Essequibo and South Savannah. It's harvest time. It's harvest time. Pastor Martin Borough had an unusual ability to blend biblical materials with practical everyday living in family life. After producing a series of lessons for pastors and laity, he acted on my suggestion to produce a series of blended Bible and healthful living. He was able to get a number of medical persons to contribute, including the late Pastor Colin Parkinson. Gordon was a genius. I began my ministry under his tutelage, from the college to the conference office, into his car, to his home, in Braden Hope, and I lived at the Martin Burroughs home for 3 months.
Thank you very much, Dr. Hilton Garnett. The timing has expired. At this time, I'm Pastor Marks. It's over to you as we bring in a UK-based tribute at this time. Pastor.
Dr. Kirk Thomas, Guyanese, who now serves in the British Union Conference, you're up next. And we thank you for being up at this time. It's probably after 10 or 11, I'm not sure, but come on in, sir, and share with the family and the rest of us. If Dr. Thomas isn't ready, we will go to the next person in the queue, and that.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Go right ahead, sir.
It's all right. Thank you. Good evening, everybody. Just want to quickly share three experiences with Pastor Martin Burrough. Most of you will know that very close to this family. Ian is my best friend. And I've received lots of kindness from this family. 1984 was the first time Pastor Martin Burrough was trying evangelism using a total lay cast. I was a young, very, very teenager then, and I was part of that. And that was a tremendous experience and blessing to me. And then when I was at CUC, Pastor Martin Burrough took me to his home to stay for 2 years, and that helped me to finish. He left me in charge of the home. He had many travels. Two quick experiences. Everybody has spoken about the brilliance of him and all his spiritual stuff and so on. I want to give you the funny side of things. One day I cooked some pepper pot, you know, the proper pepper pot, chicken foot and all kinds of things. And Pastor Martin Burrough and Mr. Martin Burrough were out on union business somewhere out of the country. And I stored it in his fridge. About 3 o'clock in the morning, they came home. They didn't tell me when they were coming. I said, wow, when I heard the gate, how do I make it to this fridge? I couldn't. So I waited until they settled down, went to bed, snuck into the house, took out the pepper pot out of the fridge, rushed it over into my little room. And the next morning, Pastor Martin Burrough knocked on my door and said, Kirk, I saw the pepper pot. He had taken the time to go into the fridge to find the pepper pot. The next thing is that he had left me in charge of the yard and the dog and so on. I was working 4 jobs, didn't have time to weed the yard. It was overgrown. The dog had developed some sort of infection. I had to call Dr. McGarrell to help me out. And they just met with me, gave me sympathy. You know, I neglected the yard and the dog. And they gave me all the sympathy in the world for my situation on the yard and the dog and everything else, forgave me. And two of my greatest experiences of sort of repaying kindness was when I managed the campaign for Pastor Martin Burrough on Durban Backlands, and we were able to baptize over 500 people there. I think that was 2004. And then I brought him and Sister Waveney up here to England, and we were able to buy the materials, distribute it to the pastors and seminars. My deepest condolences and prayers, Sister Martin Burrough. Entire family. Love from us, Carol and I and the children. May God bless you and keep you as we will see him again.
Thank you, Pastor. Thank you very much for sharing. And that element was certainly appreciated. Even pastors do bad things in people's kitchens and try to sneak around after the fact. God bless you. Thank you for sharing. We are going to bring on Dr. Carson Green, the president of the South Leeward Conference, headquartered in Antigua. Dr. Green will bring his tribute on behalf of the field he leads at this time, Dr. Carson Green.
Hello friends, I'm Dr. Carson Green, president of the South Leeward Conference, and I'm here just to share a brief tribute on behalf of a stalwart leader. When we heard of the passing of Pastor Gordon O. Martinborough, our hearts were saddened. Indeed, his life and ministry have touched the members of the South Leeward Conference constituency. We were not a separate entity when he functioned as president of the Caribbean Union or when he functioned in the Inter-American Division, but we were a part of the North Caribbean Conference. And nevertheless, his work has really impacted us. He has impacted me personally. Many of my evangelistic skills, some of you may know that I like to do family life evangelism. I learned those principles from Pastor Martinborough. Sister Martinborough, I want to say to you today that in spite of the loss, you have the assurance that he had committed his life to God. Indeed, he was humble, faithful, committed. If there is one word that I can use to describe Pastor Martinborough, I would say he was genuine. He put his all into his life work. I believe that the Caribbean Union, the South Leeward Conference, every single congregation in this territory is better off because of the work of Pastor Martinborough. He has been a stalwart of strength and support. Now that he has expired, now that he is no more, now that he is deceased, we mourn, we cry, we weep, but we do not do that as those who have no hope. We believe that very soon Jesus will come. And to you, Sister Martinborough, and the rest of the family, the South Leeward Conference's family wish to say to you today, be of good courage. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. He will be your strength and your comfort. He who raised Lazarus back to life will one of these days come and call Pastor Martinborough back to life. Then he's not coming back to life with the pains and the agony, with the troubles of this world, because then all things will be made new. We look forward to that time. May God keep you. May God bless you. May God sustain you. Again, my wife and I, along with the entire South Leeward Conference family, encourage you to trust in God. Our prayers are with you. May God bless you.
Amen. Amen. That was Dr. Carson Green, the president of the South Leeward Conference. We are going to have a song, and it's coming from the University of the Southern Caribbean, the school from which Pastor Martinborough graduated 60 years ago and eventually became its chief executive as chairman of the Board of Governors, a school he loved, a school he served. We're going to have a song from the school. After the song, there'll be a pastoral prayer for the Martinborough family. And once again, for those of you who do not know, his wife, Waveney, an amazing woman, petite but powerful, their children, Esther, her husband, Marco, their two sons, Samuel and John. Of course, Pastor Martin Borough has siblings who are alive, his sister Dolly Teixeira, married to Clement, who served in the Ghana Conference. Sister Dolly herself served at Davis Memorial Hospital a while ago. And Shirley McGarrell, Dr. Shirley McGarrell, who retired as one of the most outstanding women ever to walk on the campus of USC. And her husband, Roy, Dr. Roy McGarrell, who also retired from USC, and their children. We are going to offer a very special prayer for them and the members of the extended family. That prayer will be brought to us by a pastor. First, the song from University of the Southern Caribbean. Thank you. That's what it's all about when we come to this place in life. The great American essayist Ralph Waldo Emerson said, "Sorrow makes us all children again. The wisest know nothing." And all we have at the end of the day is our Lord, to whom we can take everything in prayer. Pastor, please come on and pray for all of us, and in a very special way for the Martinborough family. Thank you, Pastor. Just, you're ready now to go.
Let's bow our heads for the prayer. Almighty Father, we come to you this evening in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Thank you that you are God and there is none like you. We thank you for the life and ministry of Pastor Martinborough, the way you have used him in so many ways. Now you have called him to rest. We present his family in your care this evening, his wife and his children and the entire family circle, their father. We all are mourning his loss, but we can count and depend upon you that you're still the life giver. I pray in the name of Jesus that you'll comfort them. Remind them that weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. There is coming a time when death itself shall die, and Christ shall wipe away all tears from our eyes. We pray this evening, Lord, for your comfort over the family. We know it is a great loss, but in the midst of their loss, Jesus is still their refuge and strength, a very present help in time of trouble. So remind them, O God, of your grace. Remind them of your comfort. Remind them of your peace. We pray, God, this evening that you'll draw divinely close to them. And we know that one day you will put an end to death. So we have this hope that burns within our heart, hope in the coming of the Lord. We pray, God, for Sister Martinborough in a special way. We pray, Father, that you'll comfort her. We pray that you'll ease her pain. We pray that you'll lift her up when she's sad. We pray, God, that she'll see you as a friend that sticks closer than a brother. We pray for the children of God that they will surround her and that you will surround them likewise. Hold their hands. And the many lives he has touched, the ministries that he has ministered to, Father, I ask in the name of Jesus that you'll just move in a very powerful way. You are still an awesome God, and there is none like you. So into your hands, Lord, I present everyone this evening. I present the family this evening. And I pray, God, that you will so draw close to them and ease the pain that they're going through. Death is a stiller, but thank you, Lord, that you'll bring peace to them, the peace of God that passeth all understanding. This is all prayer, for we ask it in the name of Christ, all of the thanksgiving, according to your thanksgiving. Thank you, Lord, for answering all prayers. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. And we want to say thanks to Pastor Jerry Lando, who is a pastor on the island of St. Thomas in the North Caribbean Conference of Seventh-day Adventists. Of course, Pastor Martinborough, his ministry impacted the entire Caribbean Union. Hence, we are having this representation this evening. At this time, we will transition to a few tributes, written tributes. We will now explore the YouTube chat. We have in excess of 200 individuals who are watching us via YouTube. That's on the Flatbush YouTube channel and the Guyana Conference, and also on Facebook Live. So we have so many individuals. If we put the numbers together, we are well over 700. So Sister Yasmin will now read for us five tributes from the YouTube channel, after which we will be taking three open tributes. So you can just raise your hands. We'll take the first three hands. And of course, the time limit applies. Sister Yasmin.
Thank you. Thank you, Pastor White. Thank you, Pastor White. Our first tribute will come from, I'm seeing from Pastor Roderick Bishop. That's from the YouTube chat. And it says, Please accept our condolences from my wife and I and the Texas Conference of Seventh-day Adventists. The next tribute is from Leslie Tanmore. It says, Sister Martin Borrow and family, please accept my deepest sympathy on the passing of a visionary and sincere man of God. I began preaching as a layman in the 80s by using his New Life series. The next tribute, Holy Chris, it says, my condolence to the Martin Borrow family. The memory I have of Pastor Martin Borrow is his pleasant disposition and that constant smile. May he sleep in peace. Next tribute is from Ashley Hines. My sincerest condolences on the passing of Brother Gordon. Flora also sends her condolences. May God comfort you. Talk to you later. And finally, at this time, from Donna Abelwhite, sincere condolences to the family. May you find comfort even at this time. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sister Yasmin, for sharing. And these moments, we are memorializing these moments. Of course, remember to just place all of your tributes in the chat. The family will have the opportunity to sit and to read and to read. Now, we have five individuals. That's what we have. So what we are going to do at this time, we are going to give the individuals 2 minutes. That's what we are going to do. You'll have 2 minutes. So at 1 minute and a half, you will hear that music being played in the background. And then at 2 minutes, you will be muted. So we will have Sister Jem Rolier, followed by Pastor Ashton O'Neill. So Jem Rolier, Ashton O'Neill, and then we'll have Dr. Lael Caesar. So in that order, Jem Rolier, Ashton O'Neill, and Dr. Lael Caesar.
All right. Good afternoon. And I'm glad that you have allowed me to share my 2 minutes. I, looking back at Pastor Martin Borrow and his wife, Waveney Martin Borrow, was my teacher when I was in primary school, in Green Street School, Adventist School. Pastor Martin Borrow, I've seen him as an energetic, physically energetic, mentally energetic, emotionally energetic. And we know that he was spiritually energetic. He served Central very well and extended the church, the width of the church, so many feet, making it a larger church. More than that, his organizing skills at the church, the way the deacons and deaconesses and so on had to operate during his time was marvelous. I remember him when I became the head deaconess, the head superintendent, him speaking to me and he's saying, you're the head superintendent, you have to organize and you have to be there every Sabbath. Pastor Martin Borrow spent 1 hour every time he came to Central, 1 hour praying in the balcony. And of course, I have worked in several crusades as an usher and head usher when he had his spiritual programs. To the family, from my family, you know, we know what that is. You'll never forget him, but you can put your faith in God because you know what that God is, the omniscient, the omnipresent, and he is the one who looks in and cares for us. So to the family, and Sister Waveney Bartonborough from Jemrolair on behalf of the church also. You have my condolence.
Thank you very much, Pastor Ashton O'Neill.
Right, good afternoon, everyone. Firstly, let me express condolences to Sister Martin Borrow, Esther, Johnny, and Sammy. We have lost a dear friend. Now, I don't know of anyone, whether it's a member or pastor or administrator, who has made more of a contribution to the church in all areas as Pastor Gordon Martinborough. Indeed, he was a special gift to us, gift to Guyana, gift to the Caribbean Union, gift to the Inter-American Division, and gift to the world. He was an expert and provided invaluable resource material for evangelism. He was well gifted. God has blessed him with the capacity to love and to empower, to motivate, to mobilize and challenge pastors and laity. His ministry was transformational. It was enabling. It was very effective. And he blessed so many lives, thousands of lives. Indeed, this giant of a man was indeed a champion, had a tremendous passion for soul winning. The church was blessed in so many ways as a result of his ministry. We know that we are going to see him again when Jesus comes. We continue to pray for the family. May God continue to bless you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Pastor O'Neill, for sharing, recollecting the legacy of the great man who has fallen. At this time, we will take Pastor Dr. Lael Caesar and then Buxton SDA Church. Dr. Caesar.
Thank you. I don't know how many of my seconds elapsed while you were trying to decide whether I would be muted or not. But my story is brief. I'm a preacher's kid, and Martinborough was the lay activities director of the conference. And everybody all across Guyana was participating in fireside evangelism. Daddy was living in Plaisance. And I did my fireside evangelism. I was doing it with Sister Connie Overton. At one point, it became impossible for her to continue. So this neophyte went on his own. Nobody got baptized from those meetings. But it was Pastor Martinborough's initiative. My father's district did baptize more people than any other as a result of his participation in Elder Martinborough's campaign. I went to college, stopped arguing with the Holy Spirit, surrendered to the summons from heaven to be a minister of the gospel, and returned to work in Guyana. Elder Kembleton Samuel Wiggins was having one of his monumental crusades. We still called them crusades. People were being baptized up on the highway there by Redwater Creek or something. Wiggins would stand on the shore, and deacons would help a dozen people or so down into the water, and then he would declare. They brought a little boy to me, making small talk before the declaration, I now baptize you. And he said his name was Hardy. I said, you from Plaisance? Yes, he said. Everybody in my house is now Seventh-day Adventist. Sow your seed. Thank you, Ella Martin Barra. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for bringing that little kid to me so I could know that that work from years before was not in vain. See you in the kingdom.
Thank you, Dr. Caesar. We hear the passion. We hear the hurt. We are all broken. We're all broken because a giant has fallen. We will take Buxton SDA Church at this time. And then we have Carlene. And then we will take a few additional open tributes a little later. So Buxton SDA Church. Unmute, please.
My name is Reuben Earnsley Henry, an elder of the Seventh-day Adventist Church here in Buxton. The name Earnsley, I got that name from Pastor Martin Borrow because of the close ties that he had with my parents, that's George and Edna Henry. And also, I would let you know that I'm the nephew of Dr. Roy McGarrell. On behalf of the eldership and membership of the Buxton SDA Church, it is my pleasure and privilege to pay tribute to Pastor Gordon O. Martin Borrow and at the same time express condolences to his relatives and friends. This great man of God was indeed a Buxtonian who was born in a modest home in North Buxton. He had three siblings whom he grew up with in the village. His father, Brother Martin Borrow, was a dedicated first elder of the church. Brother Martin Borrow was also a police officer in the Guyana Police Force. Due to the illness of his mother, Pastor Martin Borrow and his siblings spent most of their youthful and teen years without the full attention of a mother. However, it must be noted at this point that a very dear sister of the church, by the name of Sister Agatha Mosley, took the role of nurturing him both at home and at the church. When she was alive, she would talk about Pastor Martin Borrow sitting on the benches and swinging his legs. He attended primary school in the village and walked upright and always had a smile on his face. He was baptized at a very young age and became very active in the church. Along with spiritual giants like Ruby Ganeshdin and others, Pastor McGarrell and Edna, the McGarrells, Pastor Martin Borrow became a very ardent missionary with them.
Thank you very much. And you're just reminded that you can place your written tributes in the chat. The family members, they will be delighted to read everything that you have chronicled about the life of this stalwart of the cross of Christ. Our final open tribute will come to us from Carlene Sinclair. Carlene Sinclair.
Hello and good evening, everyone. My name is Dr. Carlene Sinclair. I met Pastor and Sister Martinborough a lot later than previous speakers, but the impact is no less. I met him first when I was at South Lake Company, and then when I moved my membership to Mount Olive Seventh-day Adventist Church, I was one of his teachers. He selected me to assist him in the Sabbath school class. But more importantly, he asked me to sit on the board of the Family Life Ministry. And I can tell you that that was a time in my life where I was going through some personal issues. And I reminded him of that. And he said, and so, And so from then on, I was sitting on the board, and he has blessed my life. His wife, Sister Waveney, has blessed my daughter up until she went away to college. She was her teacher for youth Sabbath school. And both of them have been a blessing in my life. I could not give up this opportunity to say what a wonderful blessing it is for God to bring these people into my life. And I pray that even a little bit that I may have learned from them will help me to become a better Christian and to grow and to lead others to Christ. He asked me to be part of his health ministry team. The last set of videos he did, I was very reluctant, but God literally pushed me into that path. And it has been such a blessing. He has been such a blessing in my life. I sometimes I can't believe that he's gone. My prayers are with Esther and the rest of the family, especially Sister Martin Barr. We will see him in the kingdom by God's grace. Amen. Thank you.
Pastor Marks, it is now your segment. I want to say thanks to all those who have shared in the open tribute section. We have four additional names. Those names we will be taking you when we transition into the other aspect of our open tributes. But remember, you can place copious notes in the chat. Martin Burrows will read them. Dr. Pastor Marks. Okay, while we await Pastor Marks, we will take an interlude of music coming from Lyndon Assey, Elder Lyndon Assey. So we can cue that up. Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much, and covers me there with his hand. At this time, we are transitioning into our final hour of this special evening of reflection for the life of a great man, Dr. Gordon Martin Borrow. Pastor Marks, it is over to you.
Thank you, Pastor White. Thank you, everyone. We have overcome some technical difficulties we are having on this end, and we are going to move right now to complete the field presidents. We have not heard from all of them. We still must go to St. Vincent. We must also go to Tobago and Suriname. We see a lot of hands raised, but these are field presidents. They are speaking for their union, their conferences or missions, because all of the members of those fields cannot speak, so we have to allow them to have their opportunity to speak on behalf of. First, we will take St. Vincent and the Grenadines, a field led by Pastor Dermot Teest. After we hear from him, we will get Tony Mapp from Tobago. Are we ready with St. Vincent? The field presidents, most of them are pre-recorded, their statements, and so we are just waiting for that to be ready.
Death at any age and in any form or fashion is always an unwelcome intruder that brings emotional pain and deep grief to loved ones. The family of the late Dr. Gordon Martin Borrow has been grossly affected by this unpleasant reality. But not only the Martin Borrow's family, the Advent family has felt the loss as well. For his life, ministry and works transcend family, culture, territory, and church. For us in the SBG mission, he has left an endearing and enduring legacy of Christian faithfulness, manifested professionalism, and transformational leadership as he practiced his ministerial craftsmanship across the Caribbean. When he blossomed on the scene with his creative, innovative, and revolutionary series of New Life evangelistic booklets of sermons and manuals, he galvanized a number of evangelists, both pastoral and lay, who up to today use his resources in winning souls to Christ. He was a dean of preachers whose messages were piercing, profound, and penetrating. He was also a deep thinker, prolific writer, ardent listener, and bigger than life personality. He has now completed his marathon, This Side of Life, earned numerous merits of distinction, and has etched his name on the Hall of Fame of Caribbean church leaders and Christian writers. The Caribbean Union is poorer by his passing, but we are heartened by the fact that he has left an abundance of human and material resources to impact the mission of the church. SVG cherishes his legacy and commitment to excellence. Today, as we join with the family in mourning his loss, I believe the greatest memorial we can have of him is to replicate those priceless principles that he stood for and reproduce the timeless values that he lived during his lifetime. He now sleeps peacefully in Christ, whom he adored as Lord and Savior. For a child of God, death is not fatal or final, but only a comma in the sentence of life. The psalmist David speaks of passing through the valley of weeping, but not of settling or getting stuck in the dark valley. The best is yet to come. To the surviving relatives, the sun may seem to have eclipsed in your mental horizon. But be reminded that for each sunset, there is a golden sunrise, and for each stormy cloud, a colorful rainbow. We all have that enduring hope that if faithful, we shall see him again when death is swallowed up in victory. On behalf of my family, the administration and membership of the SVG Mission of Seventh-day Adventists, kindly accept our deepest sympathy and heartfelt condolences. May the comforting arms of our eternal God surround you, and may his presence overwhelm you at this time of great sadness and personal loss. May God bless you richly.
Tobago. Pastor Tony Mapp is the president of that field, and his statement will be played now.
Greetings to one and all. And these greetings come from the Tobago Mission of Seventh-day Adventists. And not only are we bringing greetings in this difficult time, but we also bring in condolences to the family of Pastor Gordon Martin Burrow, to his wife, Waveney, and to the children, friends, relatives, well-wishers. The Tobago Mission stands in solidarity with you at this most difficult time of grief. It is our prayer, knowing this man, knowing what he stood for, knowing the quality and the gifts that God has blessed him with, and the gifts that he has shared with us, we cannot help but join with you in your mourning. My dear sister Waveney, you are a wonderful individual. And I personally have experienced your kindness to this great man, your watchful care over him. I cannot forget, my dear sister, when he was conducting the crusade in Arima. At that time, I was working as a part-time worker with the church while working full-time with the Water and Sewage Authority. And in the night season coming home, as he was driving home on the highway and beginning to fall asleep on himself behind the wheel, you would nudge him along. And eventually you asked me, "Tony, can you drive?" And I took up the role of being his chauffeur to bring him home after the crusades nightly. That encounter with your family made me have an experience that I would always cherish for the rest of my life. My dear sister and the rest of the family, we cannot help but be grateful for the messages and the preparation that has been given to us on the level of health and on the level of family life. I have been impacted by his family life series, and I have preached his sermons that he has prepared and developed from them my own messages. What an awesome gift that God has given to us in this great man. We will miss him, but our eyes look beyond the grave. We look to a great day when this mortal will put on immortality, when this corruptible shall put on incorruption, and when shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. We cannot wait for the trump of God to sound and the dead in Christ to rise first. Until then, my dear sister, until then, family, we just ask you to hold on strong. Hold on, because it won't be long. May God keep you. May God bless you. We are praying for you here in the Tobago Mission, and we encourage all within the hearing of my voice to be faithful. Be faithful to the very end. God knows what he's doing, and God will save his children. May God bless you all as you are comforted with these words. God bless you. We love you.
Thanks to the field presidents of the Caribbean Union Conference, we asked and they responded with tributes and statements of condolences. We must still go to Suriname. Before we take Suriname, we want to alert you and give you an opportunity to indicate whether you'd like to participate in this segment that will be coming up. It is called our one word segment. That's O-N-E, one word, not a sentence, not a phrase, one word, an adjective. Think of a word you would use to describe Pastor Martin Borrow if he awoke you in the middle of the night. That is, of course, if you got to know him as a minister or as a layperson with your own skill set and expertise that you brought into the kingdom of grace. I want you to think of that word, and we are going to take raised hands. We're going to probably do this in half a dozen segments and give you an opportunity to give your one word, and that is because time is becoming a greater enemy. We know some of you would like to speak, but there is a funeral service tomorrow and a burial on Monday. And even though the family is not appealing, I am cognizant of that. This is going to take a toll on them. It will be a long weekend, and we want to be mindful of that. First, we will take the statement from the field president of the Suriname Mission.
Tribute from the Suriname Mission in honor of Dr. Gordon O. Martin Borrow. the Seventh-day Adventist Church in general, and in the Caribbean in particular, have lost a great leader and statesman with the passing of Pastor Gordon O. Martinborough. Born in Guyana, where he served as pastor, departmental director, and president, Pastor Martinborough proceeded to become the president of the Caribbean Union of Seventh-day Adventists, and subsequently vice president of the Inter-American Division of Seventh-day Adventists. Pastor Martinborough has exerted a great influence on Adventism in the Caribbean and even throughout the world. His influence has also reached the church in Suriname. Many persons of that era looked up to his giant, to this giant of evangelism, prayer, and family life, and a significant number of converts to Adventism can attribute their conversion directly or indirectly to his ministry. The Family Life evangelistic series has been used widely in the Suriname mission for family life seminars and evangelistic campaigns. Many families have been nurtured, relationships have been restored, and lives have been changed through this series. As president of the Caribbean Union, Pastor Martinborough had a special interest in the development of the Suriname mission. He was instrumental in providing funding to the Union and the Inter-American Division for the ministerial training of several men from Suriname as part of a special program for a specific time. The goal of this endeavor was to increase the number of local pastors in the Suriname mission. I am a fruit of this project, and I am indebted to Pastor Martinborough for his belief in me and the other men from Suriname, and his passion for the development and growth of the work in the Suriname mission. Pastor Martinborough has also assisted the Suriname mission in obtaining literature in the Dutch language through the Netherlands Union. He would allow the then president of the mission, Pastor Johan Roosevelt, the freedom to make trips to the Netherlands and enter into negotiations with the Union there to increase the cooperation between those two Dutch-speaking fields. The Suriname Mission is very grateful for the ministry of Pastor Martinborough. In many respects, his efforts have been groundbreaking, and the effects of his ministry will continue to be felt as time goes on. And ministers as well as laity continue to make use of the evangelistic tools that he has developed. His interest in Suriname mission was unabated as he, in a conversation during the meeting at the General Conference session in 2015, acquired about the condition of the Suriname field. He was interested in the membership, the number of workers, and expressed his concern for the growth of the field. We thank God for the way in which he used this servant of his and for the example that Pastor Martinborough has set, showing that there is no limit to the usefulness of one who, putting self aside, makes room for the working of the Holy Spirit upon his heart and lives a life wholly consecrated to God. On behalf of the administrators, executive committee, workers, and members of the Suriname Mission, we want to express our condolences to the Advent family with this loss, and pray that God may grant his wife and soulmate for 58 years, Sister Waveney Martinborough, their children and relatives, his peace, and may they find comfort in the assurance of the soon return of Jesus Christ, when the trump shall sound and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. God bless you all.
Amen. Amen. Obviously, we have not been stopping the videos of the presidents who pre-recorded their messages. All but two did that. The South Caribbean Conference president was live, as I recall, the president of the North Caribbean Conference. We hope you understand that we are doing our very best to move the program along and accommodate as many people as possible, which is why we now have the one word segment. And if your hand is up, we are going to call your name. If you do not want your name called, you need to check to be sure that your hand isn't up. We'll begin with the ladies. Sharon Caesar, your word to describe Gordon Martinborough.
I would say humble.
Humble, thank you very much. Margaret Dalgetty. We will go to Keith Vigilance.
A glorious man.
Glorious. You're taking one word. Cynthia Mighty.
What do you mean, can you name by?
Chose if they call my name.
Cynthia. All right, we'll go to New Amsterdam to my old friend, Randolph Bowlen Kemp. Unmute yourself, Randolph.
Okay, this is not Cynthia, it's you, Mighty. Teacher.
What's the word?
Productive.
Productive. Thank you. Can we go now to Eileen? All right. Cynthia Mighty, one more time.
You Mighty, teacher.
We heard two voices. Cynthia Mighty.
This is...
Can you take Eileen?
Hold on, we'll try to take everybody. We'll go to Margaret Dalgetty again. Please be prepared to unmute yourself as soon as you hear your name. We'll go now to Eileen. Roland Thompson. Unmute yourself, please.
Meticulous.
Meticulous. Good word. Mark Brathwaite, the doctor. Unmute and speak.
Sincere.
Sincere. Wonderful. Elder Minerva Hagebrooks. One word. All right. Thank you for giving us your word, those of you who were able to speak. I don't know if others were having technical difficulties, but if you haven't raised your hand and we are seeing some new hands up, that's good. Judy Ross, your word. Martinborough, describing. Judy? Joan?
Game changer.
Game changer. Pastor McGregor. Pastor Jerry. This isn't working as well as we wanted it to work.
Pastor McGregor's on mute. Pastor McGregor.
faithful, peaceful. Thank you, Danep, Simon. In a word.
Intentional.
Intentional. He certainly was. Elder Minerva, we are coming back to you.
Straightforward.
Straightforward. That probably resonates with a lot of us. Anybody else wishing to give a word? First, raise your hand.
Godly.
First, raise your hand. Was that you, Pastor Jerry?
Yes.
And say it again, please, so that we all hear it.
Godly.
Godly. William Cunningham.
Phenomenal.
Phenomenal. Thank you, my friend. Cyprian Bola. Unmute yourself. Cyprian.
Okay. Revolutionary.
Revolutionary. Betty Gordon and then Nicole. Betty first and then Nicole. Sister Gordon. All right, Nicole Burrows Cox.
Humble.
Humble. Janet Semple Dharma.
Genuine.
Genuine. Sandrina and then Betty Gordon. And then we'll take four more and end the segment. Sandrina. Once again,
polite.
Say that again, please.
Polite.
Polite. Polite.
Yes.
Alwyn.
Persistent.
One more time, please.
Persistent.
Persistent. Gordon Martinborough, the persistent one. Four more. Some of you haven't raised your hands, but I'm tempted to call you because I see your name. But I don't want you to embarrass me, so I'm not going to do that. Go ahead, PM CAD.
Hi, Easton.
Hi.
It's Paula. Committed. Paula. Elder Martinborough was committed. Thank you.
Thank you, Paula. Thank you very much. Very committed. We can have three others. Janet Benjamin.
Patient.
Patient. Two more. Patricia Joseph. Patricia Joseph. Valeska. Val. Val. Shirley Roberts.
I'm on mute. Okay, now I get unmuted.
Go ahead.
Unforgettable.
Unforgettable. Thank you very much. Shirley Roberts.
Oh gosh, nurturing.
Nurturing. Oh gosh would have worked too, but nurturing is better. Dawn. Dawn with the iPhone. Carlene, you're next. Dawn, go ahead.
Consistent.
Consistent. Carlene Sinclair.
Nurturing. Oh gosh, would have worked too, but nurturing is better.
Dawn.
Oh gosh, would have worked too, but nurturing
Dawn
is better.
Dawn. Carlene, did you
speak? Kind, very kind.
Kind,
very kind.
Thank you very
much. She was so kind.
So kind. Thank you. Thank you. Andre Clark.
Noble.
Noble. Thank you, sir. Patricia Joseph and C. Joy Finn. Patricia? Joseph? Unmute yourself. And then we'll come to Joy.
Awesome.
Awesome. Awesome. And last but not least, go ahead, Joy.
Priceless.
Priceless. Ladies and gentlemen, those are some of the words we have chosen to describe Pastor Martin Borrow by. Others, of course, would have other words, some of the same words. He was a good man. We lost a great one. At this time, we will have a song. It's coming out of the South Leeward Conference. And may your heart be blessed, especially Sister you, Sister Waveney, you, and again, Esther, and Sammy, and John, and of course, Marco, along with Sister Dolly and her family, and Sister Shirley and her family. Our thoughts are truly with you, and our prayers are on your behalf. The song from the South Leeward Conference.
To the family of the late Pastor Martin Borrow, I trust that the song will bring you some comfort, knowing that one day God will come and he will ease all pain and debt, and he will declare that it is finished. It is finished. There's a line that's been drawn through the ages. On that line stands the old rugged cross. On the cross, the battle is raging. For the gain of man's soul or his loss, will on one side march the forces of evil, all the demons and the devils of hell. The angels of glory, and they meet on Golgotha's hill, where the atrium with the force of the conflict. And the sun refuses to shine, for there hangs God's Son in the balance. And then through the darkness he comes. The battle is over. It is finished. There'll be no more war. It is finished. The end of the conflict. It is finished. And Jesus is Lord. Still in my heart, a battle was raging. Not all prisoners of war had come home. There were battlefields of my own making, and I didn't know that the war had been won. There
battles for me, and that victory is mine for the claiming. And now, praise his name, I am free. Well, it is finished. The battle is over. It is finished.
We thank all those who sent videos, those who are on. Obviously, we truly thank you for stopping your Sabbath afternoon, your Saturday evening, to be with the family this evening. They truly cherish that, and they will speak. Before we close, there will be a statement from them. Of course, as was previously announced, there is a funeral service tomorrow. That's going to be live streamed. Some people are going to obviously be there in person. The rest of us will join them on the live stream. And then on Monday, there's a private burial. And please let us commit ourselves to keeping the family in prayer and staying in touch with them. After the interment on Monday, the journey truly begins. And they will need, as we all do when our day comes, walking through this valley, the valley of the shadow of death. This time we will take some more entries from the chat. They'll be read to us by Yasmin Bowman. Yasmin has been a great helper in getting this program organized. And Yasmin, we thank you. Please read maybe half a dozen or so as quickly as you can. And then we will shift gears and head towards the closing.
Okay, Pastor, thank you. This one is from Nicole Burrows Cox, and she says, Sister Martinborough, Esther, Sister Martinborough, Esther, Sammy, Johnny, and all the family members and friends, sorrow is here now, but joy comes in the morning. I remember Johnny singing that song, He will be greatly missed. I saw him in Huntsville, Alabama a few years ago, and he looked better than I did. Pastor and wife Waveney were still so humble as I remember them in Guyana. God bless you all. He was a great man praying for you. Next tribute from one second. Daphne Thorpe, our condolences to the family and our prayers are with you. Hannah James, from Hannah James, former student of USC, 1961. He was a quiet and gentle giant. Waveney and family, my sincerest condolences and deepest sympathy. Someone by the name of Isaiah 49:25, never met him. However, the word for him is sacrificial. And finally, Winston Bourne, a gifted Guyanese who shared his gift with everyone. He will be greatly missed. He changed my life with Operation Andrew. I thank you.
Amen. Operation Andrew takes us back. That was the brainchild of Pastor Martin Borrow. Pastor Charles Giddens in Grenada, I believe, this evening has a quick word, and then Pastor Hugh E. McKenzie in the Guyana Conference. Charles Giddens? Pastor McKenzie.
Good afternoon, everyone. I received the call to the gospel ministry while sitting in a pew under a tent in an evangelistic campaign conducted by Pastor Martin Borrow in 1986. The campaign was held on Wisma Hill, known to the folk in Linden as Buck Hill. The victory Seventh Adventist Church in Linden was born out of that campaign. That same year I left for college. I will forever be grateful for the kindness of Pastor Gordon and Sister Waveney Martinborough, their counsel, care, and kindness during my final years at USC was a divine intervention. I'm grateful too for the privilege of lodging at their residence. It meant a lot to me as a student trying to complete my theology degree at CUC. By the grace of God, their kindness was not in vain. I will remember Pastor Martinborough as a godly, thorough, meticulous, kind-hearted pastor who poured his heart into his work for the master. He was also a pastor who could enjoy a good yoke. Sister Martinborough, may God continue to bless you and keep you, and may he be with the family, the children, and other relatives at this time. May God's grace sustain you all through this time of loss. God bless you and thank you.
Amen.
Very well said, Pastor. Very well said.
Welcome.
Pastor Charles Giddens. Please unmute Pastor Giddens if you see him out there. Unmute yourself, Charles. You're still muted. Are we the ones who are keeping him muted? Go ahead.
Good afternoon, and I must convey my condolences to Sister Waveney, Esther, Sammy, Johnny, Sister Dolly and family, Sister Shirley and family. I'll go straight to the point and say that I was exposed to preaching through Pastor Martin Borrow's training program weekend at Central Church. And at the end of that training, he asked if there were individuals who were willing to do a crusade. I just went there to participate. But Pastor Martin Borrow at that training program made preaching look so simple that I said, let me give it a shot. And so I think in 1980, I did my first lay crusade and I was delighted. What I like about Pastor Marty is that he said that he would visit the lay crusades, and one such night he did visit. Now, at a training program, at a training program years after, that's when I became a pastor, he came to Grenada and he was explaining the Family Life series and how it's done. And I asked him a question. And he said to me, Charles, use your brain, right? And that stuck with me. In other words, he was saying, I am explaining how to marry family life and the gospel. But you have to make sure you use your brain to search the Bible and see how you can do that. I am happy he told me that. So in other words, he pulled me away from the dependence of only taking his manual and do exactly what he says into expanding and searching the scripture and marrying family life with the gospel. For the past 20 years or so, I have been using my brain, Sister Waveney, as Pastor Martin Borrow said to me to do. Now, Pastor Martin Borrow, he and you, Sister Waveney, stuck with me in terms of your kindness and generosity. Because I remember being at CUC somewhere around 84, between 84 and 88. Pastor Martin Borrow made sure he gave me his yard to weed. He didn't believe in laziness and handouts just like that. He gave me his yard to weed, keep it clean, and he paid me for it. And every Christmas time, Pastor Marty and his wife made sure that we got a cake. Now, in closing, I am going to miss Martin because of his laughter. And I share this text, among other things, his laughter. The text says in 1 Samuel chapter 20 and verse 18, then Jonathan said to David, tomorrow is the new moon, and thou shalt be missed because thy seat will be empty. I thank you, Sister Waveney, and God for allowing Pastor Martin Borrow to impact on my life and the life of my family.
Thank you, Pastor Charles. Thank you. Thank you. One of these days when we come to the end, those of us who are practicing pastoral ministry, hopefully, there'll be enough people who think of us as kindly as we all think of Gordon O. Martin Borrow. I believe we have another song, a final song, and we are right about ready to hear from the family. And then we will have closing comments and hopefully keep our word to end this thing in exactly 3 hours. So at this time, we will turn our attention to the family and what they have to say this afternoon. They certainly will have more to say tomorrow and in the weeks and months ahead to all of us who shared their sorrow. Esther is firstborn, and I don't know if she's up first or if she's speaking for everyone or Sister Martin Borrow, but it's over to you, however you want to do this and however many of you wish to speak. Wonderful. Please unmute yourself. Thank you.
Yeah, I wish I could say thank you myself, but I can't. It's from my heart. Esther will speak for us.
Well, praise God, everybody. We just wanted to just express our profound gratitude for the tremendous outpouring of love and support that you have provided for myself and for my family, and for the prayers and for the phone calls, for the texts, for the cards, for the visits, for everyone being present here today. For the poetry, for the love, we just wanted to say that it has been such a tremendous comfort to each one of us
I'm speaking on behalf of my mom, my brother Sam, and my brother John, to just, you know, say that you, we're just praying that you all will be blessed, because you have provided with us, to us, each one of us, such a blessing. We wanted to say a special thanks to Pastor Marks for organizing this exceptionally well organized program. We just want to say thank you to all who have participated, for the presidents, the conference presidents, and all who have participated from all of the regions around the Caribbean and around the US. And we just wanted to say thank you for the time and care and organization and everything that has gone into planning this week, and the love that is surrounding us for this weekend. You know, we are sitting right now in inexpressible grief, but we are fervent in hope, knowing that God, who has taken us through and has brought us through every situation, that he will continue to take us and guide us, and that the God who poured out blessings upon my father will continue to pour out blessings upon us and to each one of you as you continue to do the work of God in your area and in your ministry. You know, yea, though we walk through the valley of the shadow, we're not going to fear, because God indeed is near. And you know, we are not left either in the valley or in the shadow, but a table is set before us in the very presence of all of the things that want to distress us. And our heads are anointed with oil, and our cup will run over. And so we just know that weeping may endure for a night, but we know that joy will come in the morning. We want to thank you for everything that you have done. We want to end with just legacy. You know, you have each one spoken about how my dad has touched you and your ministry and what you have been able to do. And his legacy lives through each and every one of us. And if we truly want to keep to his excellence, then we will do this work with passion, with purpose, with vision, with innovation, and with creativity. We will do this work. We will live our lives with laughter and with love. And we will, in the end, dwell with God forever. And so we wanted to say blessings to each and every one of you. And thank you so much again for all of the love. May you indeed be blessed in everything that you do. May God walk with you in his paths. Thank you again. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Sister Martinborough. Thank you, Editor Sammy, John, Sister Dolly, and Sister Shirley, to all of you. My co-hosts this evening, Pastor Sherwin White, Yasmin Bowman. Thank you. Thank you for agreeing to work through all of the stuff that we had to go through to get to 7:50 p.m. And again, thank you to Sister Martinborough and her family for allowing us to do this. Pastor White, Yasmin.
It's a privilege sharing these moments. I was introduced to Dr. Martinborough on the cover of a magazine as a young boy. His legacy, his evangelistic prowess, his leadership ability, being a true servant and pastor, ministered to me. I remember almost 20 years ago when I started ministry. I recall I was fresh out of a crusade, baptizing more than 100. And I was there in a meeting. Dr. Martinborough was there. And as I was speaking, he asked me, he said, "What's your name again?" So I said, Pastor White. He said, do you mean Brother White? I said, no, Pastor White. Because of course, all of the guys are referring to me, Pastor White, young kid on the block. I said, Pastor White. He said, no, Brother White. I said, okay, well, I did not argue with him. After he said, until the oil is placed upon you, your brother. And I remember those words and his ministry using his manuals, etc. I've been blessed. And today, to the family members, it has been a joy sharing these moments. My prayers, the prayers of my family, would remain with you. And we know that while the green heart, the kabakali, the cedar may have fallen, we know that he will rise again when Jesus comes. Thanks to everyone for your cooperation. We know at times it may have been difficult because of certain rules that we have outlined, but it is all for the family's sake. We would want to have this moment etched in their minds forever, one where they can remember those beautiful, simple words. There are a number of other individuals who have helped us along this journey. Pastor Marks, you're going to mention them by name. Those who have helped us in terms of keeping time, playing the music, the technical team. It's been a joy, and may the life of Dr. Martin Borrow, may it live on in our hearts. May his legacy propel us to become greater ambassadors for Christ. God bless you.
Thank you, Pastor White. Pastor Marks, before you respond, I have a few questions for you. I know you would have had a relationship with Pastor Martin Borrow as well. That's why you're playing such an important role this afternoon. And so I just have a couple of questions for you. In terms of one question would be, how would you describe Pastor Martin Borrow?
In a word, sentence, paragraph, my word would be modest. I would say methodical, perhaps, would be the word I would, if I really had to give one, I'd probably go with methodical.
Okay. Can you share with us, you know, how long have you known him?
Well, you know, it's no secret that I'm an admirer of pastors. I sort of grew up knowing I'd be a pastor. And at some point, I became aware that there was a Martin Borrow who had lost his voice. And then I got to know him. I think my first conversation with him was when I wanted to be a Bible worker in the Ghana conference, and he said no. And I thanked him since that day when he said no. He said to me, you're a minister, you need to go to college and not be a Bible worker. I was out of high school, I wanted something to do other than teach. And one of my pastors told me, well, maybe you can try to be a Bible worker in the conference. And so I met him and he said no. He didn't hire me because he felt I needed to leave Guyana and go to CUC. And I still thank him for not hiring me.
Okay, you give us a little bit of your interaction with him before. Can you tell us a little bit about your interaction with him after college? What was your interaction like with him after?
I never really worked with him directly as my president. He was involved in my ordination, I guess the chief officiating officer at the union level. He was the president. I remember we were sweating bullets the night, a group of us in East Carib were to be ordained, and we had heard so many terrible stories of what the men put you through on the night before ordination. And when he met with us, he said, we are not doing that tonight. We are going to interview all of you together, not singly. And we were brought in the room. It was a very straightforward, comfortable conversation. We wasted our sweat. It was not necessary. And we got ordained. he came back to Barbados while I was there and preached and lost his voice for a couple of nights. So while his voice was beginning to weaken and he stopped. And I was very honored, but scared when he told the president that he wanted me to preach for him on those off nights when he couldn't preach. And like Pastor Martin Borough, you know, very methodically sat me down and we had this long conversation about how he expected me to preach like the old Eastern Marx. And that was a lot of pressure. But, you know, I've always admired him. And his death follows on the death of Pastor Parkinson, Alan Johnson, Derek Williams, who was a member of my church. So this has been a very, you know, very, very emotional stretch to see these guys die. Derek Williams was a week or so before my mother, and then Alan Johnson, someone I also had so much connection with and admiration for, and then, of course, Colin Parkinson. And so when I heard Pastor Martin Borough died, you know, it was really a nice time. But, you know, we'll all be okay. Sister Martinborough will be okay. Not okay, okay. Esther and Sammy and John, they'll be okay. I am okay. My mother died. I didn't think I'd be okay. But Psalm 23 is right. He restoreth my soul. And Sister Martinborough, Esther, we will not stop here. We will be in touch. We will be praying. And God bless you. God bless you all. Pastor Martinborough is resting in peace. The final song is It Is Well. We heard a rendition before from Suriname. Bernadette Charles will sing this, and then we'll have our closing prayer and be on our way. God bless you all, everybody. Be safe and be well. Thank you. Canada Charles. It is well with my soul. I want to thank the ladies who assisted us, and we're happy to be in the background, but we would not have been happy if we didn't have them. They are all from my church: Ingrid Pierre, Kathy Davis, Roxanne Nora. Thank you so very much for making yourself available, not only today, but almost always when I ask. And even though you did not know the Martin Boroughs, you said yes. And we are all grateful to you for what you contributed. Of course, we also thank Pastor Hugh McKenzie of the Guyana Conference, who was working off camera until he came forward to speak his truth. And Yasmin Bowman was also doing some work in addition to what we heard and saw. I hope I didn't miss anyone. I believe I mentioned all the names. Once again, to all of you who received the invite and made yourself available, we all thank you. This is what a good community does. This is what a good church looks like. Thank you all so very much. Let's keep on keeping on. Our Lord will come again. Closing prayer will be offered at this time, and the person who is going to say that prayer, Pastor White, is?
Well, at this moment, the individual identified, I sent you a message, isn't in the position, so I shall pray on his behalf.
Go right ahead.
So let us pray. Almighty God and our Heavenly Father, we are so grateful this evening for this or these moments of reflection. We are but mortal, but we know that we are serving a God of immortality. As great a person as Dr. Martin Borough was, an excellent family man, great evangelist, a model administrator, a shepherd to the flock, that could not have inoculated him against what comes to all mortals. But we are comforted knowing that one of these days, this mortal would become immortal. Oh, Father, we remember the family. We remember Sister Waveney, the children, his siblings, oh God. Father, the road is going to be rough ahead, but we are just praying for peace in the midst of the storm. Oh, Father, may every one of us, may we pull a page from his life. He wasn't perfect, but he lived a muddled life. May we, oh God, endeavor to do the same, so when our moment comes by, it will be well with our souls. And Father, I'm praying that you would be with the family as they transition tomorrow into the funeral service, and then on Monday, that burial. May they look forth with eager anticipation for that day when the trumpet shall sound, and when Jesus himself will call forth your son. He would call forth Gordon by name. And oh God, I pray that as you clothe him in immortality, that everyone on this platform, we too will be changed, and we will live those ceaseless ages of eternity with you. So Father, until then, keep us, we pray, in your holy and blessed name. Amen and amen. Amen. God bless you.
God bless you, Sister Waveney, Esther, and to the rest of the family. Have a good night. God bless you. Be well. Everyone, be safe and be well.
God bless.
God bless you all. Pastor McKenzie. Well.
Promise to all who are faithful, is of that glorious land.